Okay, let's talk about threat models. So far, we've talked about our villains, Eve and Mallory, and we've said Eve is able to eavesdrop on messages, and Mallory is able to listen on messages and also change them, tamper with them. But those might not be the only things that Eve and Mallory can do. Maybe Eve and Mallory have more powers that we don't know about. And so if it's the case that Eve and Mallory have more powers, we have to develop new threat models to account for the fact that Eve and Mallory can do more things than just eavesdrop. And remember, the reason why we're doing this is not because Eve and Mallory are real people who can come and attack us. They're all fictional. The reason why Eve and Mallory are being used is because we are trying to model real-world attackers. In other words, Eve and Mallory are fictional characters, but we're trying to use them to model attackers that really do exist in real life. And because real life attackers can do more things besides eavesdropping and tampering with messages, we might also sometimes want to give Eve and Mallory, our fictional characters, some more powers so that they more accurately represent the sophisticated attackers that you can encounter in real life. So at least for this class, we're going to look at four different models that we can use to give Eve and Mallory different abilities. And depending on what you think is happening in real life, you can choose the model that's most appropriate for your system. So here we're going to look at threat models for confidentiality in particular. So we'll think about encrypting and decrypting. We'll come back to integrity later. So let's think about Eve, the eavesdropper, and possibly giving her extra powers. So the two extra powers that we can confer to Eve, depending on our threat model, are these two. One is, can Eve trick Alice into encrypting messages that she chooses? So can Eve walk up to Alice and say, I really want you to encrypt potato with your key? And if Alice can get tricked into faithfully encrypting the word potato using Alice's secret key, then we say Eve has this ability. She can trick Alice into encrypting any message she wants. And on the other side, can Eve trick Bob into decrypting messages? So can Eve walk up to Bob and say, here's this sequence of ones and zeros. Can you use your key to decrypt this for me? And if Eve is able to trick Bob into doing this, then we say Eve has the second power. So those are the two things that Eve might be able to do. And we have all four combinations here. Each one has a term. If Eve is able to do neither of these things, she is only able to eavesdrop. We call that the ciphertext only model, for reasons that will probably become more clear later. If Eve is able to encrypt her own messages, that is, trick Alice into using her key to encrypt messages, but she cannot trick Bob into decrypting messages, that's called chosen plaintext. If you have the other combination where she cannot encrypt, but she can decrypt, we call that chosen ciphertext. And if she can do both, she can trick Alice into encrypting messages of her choice, she can trick Bob into decrypting messages, that's called chosen plaintext. Ciphertext, it is the most powerful of the four models. So for this class, we are just going to focus on one of them. We'll think about chosen plaintext, which means that Eve is able to trick Alice into encrypting messages using Alice's secret key. So Eve doesn't know the key, but she's going to trick Alice into using her key to help out Eve. But she cannot trick Bob into decrypting messages. That's what we're going to use. In practice, it is actually commonplace to use this last one, the most powerful one, because it models the most powerful attackers. So if you can defend against that fourth one, the most powerful one, you must have a pretty good cryptographic protocol. So real-life cryptographers often target the most powerful one to try and stop as many attackers as possible. But for this class, we'll stick to this one. And at the risk of overloading you too much, one final footnote is, when you're decrypting messages, you cannot decrypt the... Should I say that? I'll say it real quick. If you trick Bob into decrypting messages, you can't trick Bob into decrypting the thing you encrypted. That would defeat the whole point. Very minor footnote.